Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. You may remember our next guest from his hit role in the movie Hardball, but he's all grown up now. He's playing Kisan Teague in HBO's Ballers. Take a look. Yes.
What, we watching a movie together or something?
Yeah, it's a thriller. Yet to be released, but something tells me you already seen it. How about we cut to the chase and you tell us how it ends?
Well, you sure you want to know? We don't want to put you in a precarious position.
Try me.
All right, look, I was grabbing a burger with my boys, right? And the next thing I know, I'm in the middle of Unforgiven.
So you're admitting that your boys participated?
Yeah, and I'm lucky they did, too. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here to tell you the truth.
Ooh. Wow. All right, good people. Let's welcome actor Kris Lofton to the circle.
Yes!
What's up, Kris?
How y'all doing?
How you doing?
Hey, I appreciate y'all.
Hey, hey, hey.
Yeah, of course.
Wow. How y'all doing?
Sit down.
Sit down.
It's nice. I don't want to touch that. I feel like my mama has.
This really is the living room that we're not supposed
That's
to
right.
be in.
That's right. I can tell. Look at the
camera. Can't see on the
couch. You ever just rub your leather?
Soft leather, baby, like butter.
Oh, yes.
All right. So listen, we want to talk a little bit about Hardball. Uh-oh. Everyone knows you from that. Like, mm-hmm. And then you took a little, that was in 2001. Mm-hmm. And then you took a little bit of a hiatus. Mm-hmm. And then you came back with a vengeance. What was it like making that transition from being a young actor to now a man mm-hmm. in the business? And what would you say that you've learned the most since then?
Oh, well, I would say that transition was kind of, you know, it could get scary at first. Because mm-hmm. when you're a kid starting out that young, you don't really realize the magnitude of what it is you're doing.
Right.
You just think it's cute, it's fun. Mama's happy, daddy happy, mm-hmm. family happy, you kind of happy. You just like, you know, I'm doing this. But right. I didn't really realize the magnitude of what it was I was doing. I didn't realize it was like an escape. It was another way.
Wow.
You know, so. Yeah. It didn't really, that's where that hiatus came from. It was like, I was a kid, I didn't know I wanted to act. I still wanted to play sports. I had I was focused on that. I had a full ride to college to go to Grambling State
right,
to play football and baseball. And I turned it down and keep acting. So that's where that hiatus came where I was still battling, deciding if I wanted to play sports, or if I wanted to act. And that's.
Do you feel like you made the right decision?
Oh, 100%.
Right. Well, now you get to merge the two.
Yes, ma'am, 100%.
Yes, 100%. Yes.
It's just the upside wasn't there with me with sports. It's just mm-hmm. the risk didn't match the reward to me.
Okay, I got you.
Yeah, because based on that trailer, you know, things aren't looking that great for Kisan.
Yeah, no, Kisan's on one. I haven't even seen it. I was back there watching it like, wait a minute, what clip did they say? I ain't never even seen this. I was watching it. I almost missed McHugh. I swear I did. I was watching it. I was like, I've never seen this.
So how are things going to be for him this last season?
Oh man, crazy! I don't know if you haven't watched it before. It's cool. It does. Hey, it's cool. Just watch it now, and you can see my character. He gonna grow like from season 3 and 4. Mm. He grows, but also he kind of had that survivor's remorse about him, you know, because he's that dude that's kind of the wild card, kind of come from that inner city hood kind of environment with his friends. So he has that bit of survivor's remorse that kind of makes him feel like his friends should be there with him, and sometimes those friends get you in trouble.
Yeah, man, that make it syndrome. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
you know, you gotta pull everybody up with you. You can't. Everybody's not supposed to take that ride with you.
Right, that's what Mama said. Everybody can't go with you.
Everybody can't go with you.
She probably watching this right now.
Yes.
She woke up. My mama live in Georgia. She she is probably watching this right now. She is probably. I promise you, she is.
True. are there any similarities between your personality and Kisan's?
Yes, me and Kisan are kind of one and the same, but he's like the 22-year-old version of Kris, the Kris that don't have no common sense, the Kris that was kind of who acted more on impulse and didn't like take the time to think about his thoughts before he acts on them, and just the less reserved. So when Kris was like 21, 22, a little wild, that was more so Kisan. And if Kris was a multimillionaire with like 40, 50 million in the bank, you know?
Oh, that's a fool right there.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So, like, it wasn't hard to play him. I just, you know, had to think about what would I say right now if this person said that to me and I had $50 million in the bank and I just didn't care? What would I say? And
it's
action. And then they say action. And then it's like, oh, this is going to be easy.
Right, exactly. What was it like for you to work with The Rock?
The Rock is amazing. He, right? I mean, that dude, he kind of puts it in perspective for you. He kind of just makes
you. What'd you learn from him?
I learned that, like, there's work begets more work.
Mm-hmm.
Work definitely begets more work. And I learned that no matter what level you're at, what magnitude, like, you you gotta always show that appreciation and that humility, and that's what sticks out with people.
Did
you know what I'm
saying?
Did
he show a little appreciation and invite you to the wedding?
You know, I'm still waiting on that invitation. I think it got lost in the mail. What had happened was he had DM'd me.
Yes.
And then I had read it and said read, but I didn't press send the reply. Yes. That's what happened. That's why I didn't go. I'm sorry, Dwayne. I apologize for missing.
What kind of gift do you give someone like him?
Nothing. You tell him congratulations. I wouldn't. I'm not giving him nothing. Like, I'm going to just tell you like that. I'm not even going to play and pretend. Like, it's not the thought that counts. Not in that case.
All right, now, so you stay where you are, and then you guys stay right where you are, because when we return, we're playing a game called Flag on the Play with Kris Lofton. You don't want to miss it. Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We are here with actor Kris Lofton.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. So I got to keep it real with you, and I just got to find out. You know, Rashawn said it's football season approaching, right?
Indeed. I can't wait.
Who's your favorite football team, and who's your favorite football player?
Favorite team, I'm from Chicago, so I'm going to go with the Bears, but I do love the Raiders, too. I'm a Raiders fan as well.
Okay.
Favorite player, I'm going to go defense, and I just like the Wild. I like Wild Boys. I'm going to go with Keeb Tlaib, man. That's my boy. And that's like my friend.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Keeb. That's my boy, man. Akeeb, he a real one. Yeah.
I like these. He a real one.
Yeah, he a real. I like that.
We're going to see how real you keep it. We're going to play this game called Flag on the Play.
All right.
Okay. All right. So you tell us, is this a flag on the play or not? Okay. So, and I'm going to kick it off.
All right, let's do it.
Okay. Popeye's running out of chicken.
That's a flag on the play.
Right.
That's a flag on the play because y'all knew in February this release was going to happen. No, but I did read something on Twitter where they said they thought that they would have chicken until October.
It's a chicken place.
It's a drought.
No, they thought they had enough chicken sandwiches to last them until October.
Okay. Did you have one?
Oh, of course I had one. I actually waited in the line. I felt so bad. That was like my lowest black moment. Waiting. That might be top three lowest black moment. I waited in that line for about 18 minutes for that sandwich. I swear I did. I felt so bad, but I had to do it. I couldn't stand myself, but I did it.
All right, I got another one. Now, Wendy Williams says she has to go out on a date with a guy at least 30 times before she snatched that wig off. Is it a flag on the play?
Super flag on the play, just first off, because it's Wendy Williams who had the audacity to say that. And secondly, because it's Cap. I just don't know. I don't want to hear
it. So you don't want to take her wig off like on the first date?
Not necessarily the first. And then when it's the woman role, I understand that y'all are a little bit more, you know, sensitive to that.
What you do on the first date?
That's you're funny. this is a family show. There are children watching this. I just try to do. I try to lay it all out there. I believe in transparency. I'm gonna just say
so
that.
So you fart on the first date.
I might not take it that far, but I'm not. I ain't finna hold mine either though for nobody.
Okay. What about giving your phone number to fans?
In the DM or in person, that's subjective.
Ooh.
It's subjective.
We'll see.
Very much so subjective. I'm a deep thinker. You got to give me some more than that.
So you would with the DM, though?
No. The DM's a little bit more weird because I don't know who behind that. But if I meet you in person and you just so happen to be a fan, but the energy was right, I'm very intuitive, I might.
So Kris might holler at a fan.
I ain't say holler. You say get my number.
Well, we're going to have you back to ask you some more questions. So we thank you for joining us today. And don't forget to catch Ballers, the final season. Can't believe it. Sunday nights, 10:30 p.m. Eastern on HBO.
Conversations always continue on Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms.
Yeah. Thank y'all.